Hello everyone, I'm John and welcome back to the channel. If you already have a telescope and a smartphone, you might wonder, do I need a planetary camera to capture the moon or the planets? Well, you'll be able to find the answer by watching this video. I'll be using a small refractor telescope to capture the moon by using an affordable smartphone and an affordable planetary camera, the Touptek Astro G3M715c. You can see the telescope and the camera connected, and now it remains to connect to the mini PC, find the moon and start the capture. After that, I will attach an eyepiece with a smartphone adapter and I will use my smartphone here to capture the moon. Let's see the results, smartphone versus camera. We'll go now to the mini PC. Now we just need to turn the camera. Rotate the camera. Got it. You managed to do it. And let's hit the record button. It will record on in surfile. Frame rate 45. Oh, it does work much faster right now. Okay, says we have 6800 frames. Full HD. Okay. And let's capture this area here. Okay. Apply. And record. We have don't have too much space, so this will be a short video. Already have 400 frames, so it's going 87 frames per second. That's very fast. Yeah, look how many. 20 seconds, 2000 frames. That's just amazing. The setup. I place a diagonal mirror, a normal budget eyepiece of 10 mm, nothing expensive. I do use the same telescope that has an autofocuser. I'll use here the remote from the ZW autofocuser to focus first. Here we have the moon, and here it is. Okay, now let's place it on the phone adapter. Here we have it. Okay. So we got focus. This is autofocus basically. We'll lock it and okay, so now I'm capturing the moon using my smartphone and the short focaling telescope. And I will compare this video with a portable camera from Touptek, a 4K camera. After this we'll test with an expensive eyepiece. Let's see if we can beat now the camera. This eyepiece will cost more than the camera. So basically using more expensive equipment. I think now we are getting closer with the quality of the Touptek by adding a more expensive eyepiece. It's now time to see the comparison between the video results captured with the smartphone and with the planetary camera. But before we begin, I do want to mention first that when using a camera, we had prime focus. That means we use directly the camera attached to the telescope to capture and focus the light without using any other eyepieces or lenses. And when we use the smartphone, we had a focal focus. That means we needed also an eyepiece to be able to focus the light. And this is very important because even if smartphones got much better, we are still restricted to this type of imaging that has also this lens in front. We need to place also the eyepiece. And in this case, I used also a diagonal mirror. Let's show now also the comparison videos. Here we can see the smartphone video that I captured with a 10 millimeter budget eyepiece and also the moon video captured with the planetary camera. On the smartphone capture, we can see on the edges of the video distortions and chromatic aberration like purple or yellow color fringe. And on the video that I captured with the planetary camera, we won't see that, because we use the camera directly attached to the telescope and the light went directly into the camera sensor. Now let's check the image tags that I obtained by capturing the moon using the smartphone and the planetary camera. We have here our first image tag that I obtained by the video captured with a 10 millimeter eyepiece with the budget one. We can already see here that the image is not great. We have also some chromatic aberration. We can see this blue fringe here on the edge. Let's compare with the planetary camera. Notice here we do not have any fringe and the details contrast is much better. Now let's check the next image. For this one I used the Beider Hyperion 5mm eyepiece. It's a much better quality eyepiece and we can see the improvement in image quality. However, if we go off its screen and look here on the edges of the image, the focus was not good and we also have a chromatic aberration. Let's go now on the upper part of the image, zoomed in, and here we can see the Gaziantep crater in much better details than on the first capture with the smartphone. However, comparing this image that has a good contrast, this area with good contrast on the Terminator, with the image capture with the planetary camera, it's very clear that we do have sharper details here on the planetary camera image, also on the lunar surface, and much better image quality, less noise, better contrast and sharper details. Now let's move to Copernicus crater and here the difference is even bigger. Check out the planetary camera image. So many details here in the Copernicus crater that were lost in the smartphone image. Okay, and now let's zoom also here and check Plato crater and Sinus Iridum. The image is blurry and also have much more chromatic aberration here on the mountain's edge from Sinus Iridum region. Prime focus definitely has the edge and just using an affordable planetary camera will give us sharper results with better contrast and also with no chromatic aberration and without distortions. Hope the video was useful and it will also help you decide if you want to upgrade from a smartphone to a planetary camera. And if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like it, subscribe to the channel if you're new, and if you like to support the channel more, don't forget to check the channel membership. There you can join and become a member of the channel and get also access to unique perks like downloading my astrophotography data. And I also make these imaging stacks from smartphone and planetary camera available for channel members. I wish you all clear sky and I hope I see you in the next video.